Hi everyone! In this video, we will walk through the main updates in V-Ray 5, Update 2 for 3ds Max. First, we have the Cosmos materials. So, if you open the Cosmos browser, here is the new category Materials. Moreover, in the What's New section, you can see that we also have new models added. Let's click on the Materials category and we can see several subcategories. I will go to wood and randomly select this wood. First, we need to download it in order to use it, so I will click on this button. And then simply drag and drop it in the scene. In order to adjust it, open the material editor, use the Pick Material from Object command and click on the material. Our material is transferred in the material editor and we can adjust it. Let me also assign it to the other wooden surfaces and produce a render. If we are using the interactive rendering, we can download a few wood materials that we like and simply drag and drop them in the scene while rendering to see how they look and make our final selection. Another update is the addition of the Sharpen Blur effect in the V-Ray Frame Buffer window. Let me produce a render. If I zoom in, you can see that it looks blurry here since my render is of low resolution. To enable the Sharpen Blur effect, I will select the layer and click this checkbox. Then, I will set the blur radius to 0 since I don't want to blur my image and I will play with the sharpen amount and radius. If I use the eye icon next to the sharpen blur layer, you can see the before and after. So our image now looks sharper. Another addition to the frame buffer window is the log window. If you recall, in previous versions we had a separate window for this. Now it is integrated in the VFB window. A pretty cool new feature is V-Ray Decal. You can access it if you click on this button in the V-Ray toolbar. Let me go to the floor plan viewport. Click and drag and you will see this shape that is created. I will click to set its size and then I will drag to specify the height. Check the other viewports as well to understand the height of the shape. And let me move it on the nightstand. I will now open the material browser, go to the liquids and choose coffee. I will drag it in the material editor and I will assign it to the V-Ray Decal. Let's produce a render. So, what happened? Coffee is, let's say, split inside the area marked by our shape. You can see that here it doesn't cover the whole nightstand. This has to do with the angle. If I increase the angle and instead of 90, I make it 130, the effect is extended. While if I decrease the angle, let's say to 40 degrees, then the effect is reduced. Let me take the angle back to 90. And let's now see the mask. I have downloaded from the web this black and white image of a coffee cup stain. I will click on the None button next to the mask setting and I will load this photo. You can now see that the coffee material gets the shape of our mask. I will also reduce the size of the V-Ray decal to match the size of a coffee mug to make it look realistic and to move it on the nightstand. Or I can move it on the bed. See how easy it is to adjust it? With V-Ray Decal, we can add some pretty cool details in our render. Finally, a great improvement in the latest V-Ray release is the material override. First, let me change my flooring and add a stone texture I downloaded from textures.com. If I do a crop render, it looks pretty flat. Let me now add the displacement map and do a new render. Now we have the feeling that our stone floor is three-dimensional. And now, let's do a clay render. If you don't know what a clay render is, please check the respective video I have uploaded in my YouTube channel. So, let me create a default V-Ray material and override the scene with this. Here is the result we get, so the floor looks flat and we no longer see the displacement effect. In this latest version of V-Ray, I can click on the Override Material button and here is a list of all the attributes we can preserve. So I will basically enable all of them. If I now render, we can see the displacement of the surfaces, the reflections, opacity, etc. and everything is preserved. So this is pretty cool now. So these are the new features that I use from the latest update of V-Ray 5. I hope you will also find them useful and use them in your renders. Thanks for watching. I will see you all in my next video.